Welcome, everyone. I'm Raghu Ramakrishnan, the CTO for Data and a technical fellow here at Microsoft. I'm going to now take you through one part of what you have heard, lineage, and show you what's under the hood. So why do I care about lineage? There are a wide range of scenarios, ranging from impact analysis, root cause analysis, monitoring compliance, fair and responsible AI, of interest to virtually everyone who's associated with data in any way, from data officers to privacy officers to data scientists and engineers. Let's take an example. If you consider this SQL query, right, there is a stored procedure executing the query you see here, and it produces an output table based on joining two input tables. And in this case, figuring out where each column of the output came to be, which column of the input tables of which input tables it came from, is straightforward. You can do this by static analysis of the SQL program. However, static analysis isn't a powerful enough tool. For one thing, when there are triggers, as in this example, you don't know when they execute, and consequently what that does to the lineage of the resulting data. When you have dynamic SQL, even the string that's executed is not known. The actual SQL query is laid bound. Yeah, the next example, if there's an if-then, a conditional in your stored procedure, then until runtime, you don't know which branch you're going to take. And depending on the branch that's taken, the derivation of your data will differ. With static analysis, you can only say the output depends on this or this or this input. Whereas in reality, at runtime, you'll actually know that it depends on precisely one of those branches, one of those inputs. Lastly, the nature of transactions. If a transaction fails, the statement you're talking about may never be committed, right? Again, you only know this at runtime. So static analysis will give you lineage, true, but with a big asterisk. And it's going to miss out on a slew of valuable information that's only available to you at runtime. So what you really want to do is take advantage of runtime telemetry. And fortunately, in the SQL Server universe, we have X events. X events contain pretty much all the information we just talked about. You know, whether it's information about the user running the query, the actual query string that was executed, the timestamp when it was executed, and so on. However, if you try to take all this information in the X events and try to extract lineage in a straightforward way, you are going to have a tough time of it. It's like an overloaded truck. There's simply too much information and too much noise, repeated loops, a whole collection of things that are not of interest to what you're looking to get lineage information on. It's simply too expensive. However, we have put in a ton of work, a whole slew of optimizations, ranging from loop optimizations to eliminating irrelevant events to massive compression. Taken together, we can speed this whole thing up by over four orders of magnitude. That's a factor of 10,000 I'm talking about. And that is the version of dynamic lineage extraction that you actually see for SQL Server in Purview. Next time you see lineage for a SQL Server stored procedure in Purview, you know the story behind how it came to be. And in fact, if you were actually to double click on that node in the Purview lineage graph, you would see all the information we just talked about. Thank you.